Hello everyone, my name is Don Takacs. Thank you so much for stopping by today. Today, I have been working on a pattern that I think solves two problems. First, when you wear glasses and they fog up from your face mask and people put wires in it to help alleviate that problem, but it just creates another problem because not all wires are the same and they rust and they tear through the fabric and it's not a good idea. The wires is just not a good idea. I've solved that problem. And additionally, I have solved another problem, and that is for men with beards, whether it's a short beard or a long beard, and they need a mask that's comfortable for them. And this is inspired by my nephew, Tim. I'm going to shout out to him. That being said, I want to get right to it and teach you a little bit about this new design. So if you're new to my channel, thank you for stopping by. My name is Dawn Takacs. I'm the Streamline Seamstress. I have over 4 decades of sewing. I owned a sewing factory, and this channel is all about sharing my tips, tricks, and hacks with you to save you time, money, and energy. And if you're down with that, make sure to subscribe to the channel, ring the notification bell so that you'll be notified when I post a new video. Masks that we're making today is made out of flannel, and flannel is designed for baby wear, blankets, bedding, diapers, onesies, anything that absorbs water. We make a lot of things that need to absorb water out of flannel, and so it's the perfect solution for this mask. We created a nose bridge in the mask, and instead of having a wire there, we have just a little piece of flannel in that nose bridge, and what it does is it captures carbon dioxide as the person's speaking, and it just grabs it and holds it so that glasses do not fog. And I'm going to show that to you a little bit later in this video. And then the bearded mask, we made it so it's adjustable, so you can go from short to mid to long as needed, and whoever is wearing it, they can just adjust it as needed. They've got the nose bridge, so they don't have to worry about glasses. It's just a great mix. I'm really excited to show this to you. So let's do it. Let's get to the sewing table.
We have our template pattern here in plastic, and I make these, I transfer all my patterns to this plastic, and I love it because it has this grid on the back that keeps the template from slipping. And I'm going to pop in that video for you if you want to learn more about that. But here's our template, and it's two pieces, the mask body, the lining, and the nose bridge. And we want to make sure that we're laying this with the cross grain and also the direction of the greater stretch with the jersey knit. And you can see that's got a great deal of stretch there and just a little stretch this way. There's always one way that's greater than the other, and that's the direction that we want going across the face or across the body if you were making something such as a skirt. I'm gonna give this a quick cut. Then I am going to fold it in half, and then I'm just going to notch those corners really quick with my rotary matten wheel. You can use scissors. I just want to notch that center because I want to be able to match it up with the woven. And here we are. We have the plaid tartan that I'm working with today. There's my selvage edge. The selvage edge runs the length of the bolt. And the cross grain is going from selvage to selvage in this direction, and then your main grain line is going the length of the bolt. A woven fabric, you can see, I can easily pull the threads out of it. So I'm going to show you a couple different things here so that you can find your grain line and get a nice straight cut. One of them is you can make a little nip in the fabric, and then you can just literally rip it. And when you rip this fabric, it's going to rip straight down the grain line. I pulled the thread a little bit and gathered it in, but you can see this is a perfect cut on the grain line there. It's got a little bit of fringing there. You can cut that off, but that just gives you a perfectly cut piece. You can also pull string through and just gently, like you're gathering a thread, if you were making something with a gather and you were doing it manually, we just want to pull that thread through. And that's going to give us a nice line to use for cutting. Now, obviously, we're cutting a tartan today. We can see the lines in the grain, but if you were not using a fabric that where you could visually see the lines, maybe it was a print of some sort, that would be a great way for you to be able to find the grain line and cut it right on the grain line. I am cutting the length of the mask right now. I used my template and measured it. And then I'm going to take the mask and find the proper allocation for my design to make it symmetrical. So I've got the length, and now I'm just going to use my template. I am going to find what I want to be my center and then determine what lines on the left and the right match up best. And I'm going to cut right on those lines because I want everything to be nice and symmetrical when I go to put this together. And as you can see, that turned out beautiful. We've ended up cutting on the same line on both sides. And now I'm going to fold this in half, and I am going to match up my lines of the plaid on either side. And I'm just going to notch with scissors. I did it earlier with a ruler and a wheel, but at the moment, I'm just going to give a little tiny notch so that I can mark my center. This is going to be very important to me. When I go to put everything together, it's going to help tremendously. Now we're going to cut the nose panel on the diagonal or on the bias. So to find the bias, we are going to fold on a 90 degree angle between the grain line and the cross grain line. And you can see those lines on the fabric that are running across the top and up and down. And I've just folded it on a 90 degree angle. And that's going to give me a perfect cut on the diagonal or on the bias. And I'm cutting this on the bias because A, I want the way that it looks with the plaid. I think it looks lovely. And B, just to give it a little bit of stretch. So, and I'm going to fold that in half. I'm going to take it to the pressing mat and just give it a quick press. This is just one panel. Sometimes with the tartan, it's hard to determine the inside and outside, and the outside of the fabric is always a little bit more vivid, if that helps anyone. I'm just going to give it a quick press. I'm actually making two masks, so if you see an extra piece in the video, it's allocated for the second mask. There it is. We're working on some gifts of love to some family members. I'm also going to take the main mask body and I'm going to give it a nice press, just to get out any wrinkles. So there's my notch I made in the center, and I am going to take the sharp point of the nose bridge. Now keep in mind, we did press this and fold it. I'm going to put right sides together, and I'm going to pin the center together. So I have allocated dead center with my notch in the point of the nose bridge. And then I'm going to just carefully pin going from center to the right until I can no longer pin anymore. I just want to get that placed perfectly. And then I'm going to do the same thing going from the center to the left. And this way we know that that's perfectly centered when we start from the center and work our way on both sides. And now I'm just going to give this a quick baste. If you're more experienced, you could also pin in the lining at this point, but because of the pivot, the turn, the extra fabric underneath where that point is, I think it's a good idea just to give it a quick baste, remove the pins, make it easy on yourself. It takes like, you know, a whole 30 seconds here to make this seam. And I'm doing this just at like an eighth of an inch or a quarter inch, just to baste it in, no back tack or anything. Just let's get it in. I'm working with a Microtex needle today. I love Microtex needles for wovens. They also fare well with knits. So just a helpful hint there. And because we're doing a hybrid here with two different fabrics, I'm checking my stretch here. The stretch is going across the face and the width of the garment I'm taking the notch that I made on the knit and I'm matching it up right sides together, and I'm matching it up with that triangle at the top in the center. And I'm going to do the same thing I just did with the nose panel. I'm going to start at the center and I'm going to pin as far as I can go to the right, all the way to the right edge. Make sure everything's placed beautifully, and then I'm going to repeat that process starting at the center and work my way all the way to the left. And this way I know that that lining panel is in there perfectly from center to the right and center to the left. It's a little awkward because that nose bridge creates this inverted V. It's not like it's a straight line going across. And I'm double checking underneath to make sure that I'm not layering any fabric or getting more than I intended to. And once I get this set, I am going to take it to the machine and give it a stitch at 3/8 of an inch, about 12 stitches per inch. I'm using 100% polyester Guterman's thread, which is my go-to, and that Microtex needle. And I'm using my trusty pointer to help keep that knit nice and flat in between pins. You can sew over pins as long as they lay like railroad tracks. Here you can see if the machine was the train and the railroad tracks were directly in front of them, horizontal. And I'm going to pivot and turn, and I am going to just finish this up. I'm going to make sure to back tack at the end here to keep it nice and secure. I'm checking my fabric underneath because I just did that pivot to make sure I don't have any excess bulk underneath and I'm not catching the body of the mask. I actually really love this design. It's comfortable, it's breathable. It looks great on men. Every man that I've made it for has loved it. Even the men with glasses have given me kudos on what a great design it is. And so now I have put a little clip dead center just to the thread where that point was on the nose bridge. And I'm going to take my pinking shears and I am going to trim as close to that 3/8 of an inch seam we just made as possible. I just want to remove the excess bulk. And because I clipped it in the middle close to the seam at the very tip of the center, makes it easy for me to do. And I probably should do this on the cutting mat or a flat surface, but then I would have to move the camera. And so I'm going rogue with you today. All right. And now we just want to do a top stitch. I've turned it right side out and I'm going to top stitch at 1/8 of an inch, as close as I can get, just to secure that inside seam allowance. We just want to get that nice and sewn in so it doesn't move on us and give the mask a nice shape. I can tell you, I love sewing in the winter. I love working with plaids and tartans. They're so gorgeous. And so now that we have completed the top part of the mask, we're going to do the bottom with the right sides together. I'm going to sew a straight stitch at 3/8 of an inch on the bottom. And I'm going to use one of the lines from the plaid as my guideline, because that way then everything will turn out beautifully and symmetrically. And that's what we want when we make a garment with a plaid. And a back tack at the beginning and the end. I'm going to remove those pins, and I'm also going to use my pinking shears and trim close. We want to keep that tartan from fraying on the inside, and we want to remove the excess bulk. We want a nice thin seam there. So I did take the left and the right, and I did an overlock with my serger to finish the edges. You can also tuck it in and straight stitch it down. You can do an overlock on your sewing machine. And I just real quickly just did a zip. You can also technically cut it with your pinking shears and do a zigzag here if you want. but on the left and right side, I'm sewing at 3/8 of an inch to sew in a casing, and that casing is going to be for the drawstring for the mask. And I am doing the left side first. And look at how gorgeous that navy looks on the inside. This technically turns out where you could wear it on either side. You can use a rayon knit, a jersey knit, a cotton lycra. Today I'm using a jersey knit that's got this beautiful body and feel. It's soft and subtle. I've been working with it a lot over the last 6 months and people love it. And a little back tack there to secure. Fabulous. And now we're going to cut the string for the mask. So I'm going to cut this at 3/4 of an inch, but you could also go up to an inch if you want. And I'm using my ruler and I've got my fabric weight there to hold, to be my third hand for me. I'm just going to give it a straight cut. The most important part of this cut is to make sure that you're cutting in the direction of the greater stretch. You want to make sure that this is how you've laid it. Most knits or lycras stretch two ways, some stretch four ways. You want to go in the direction of the greatest stretch, because when you pull this, it creates this beautiful elastic string that you can use for your ear loops, neck loop. And in this case, this is going to be a combination. It's going to go behind the head. It's going to brace on the ears, and then it will go behind the neck and have a drawstring that can be adjusted. And it's soft, it's comfortable. People do not even realize that they're wearing it. That's how comfortable it is when you make this out of a jersey or a lycra fabric. Am I definitely a 5-star on this is the way to go? Make sure, though, you're cutting it in the correct direction with the greater stretch. So we have our panel for our mask, and this is a medium mask. And we have, I believe, up to sizes extra large. And you can see I've got that casing on the left and the right. And I'm going to start on the lower right. I'm going to take my Dritz loop turner. And you can see it has a little fishing hook on the edge here. This is just like fishing. We're going to just push this. And it's got a little closure clasp there too, a little lobster clasp. But we're just going to push that through. And we're just going to grab that string. And I'm just going to pull that string right through that casing. Now, if you don't have a turner, you could use a safety pin. I'm going to put the link below for all the supplies that I used today, the plastic for the pattern template, and then the fabric weights, my iron, my pin cushion. I've got a video for that. All that I'm going to put in the description for you because people always ask. But now I'm going to start. I pulled that through one side, and now I'm going to take that turner at the top of the mask, and I can tell the top because of the nose bridge, and I'm going to pull the string through from the top to the bottom. So we want the tails on the string at the bottom and a loop at the top that's going to be actually over the head and over the ears. And I'm just kind of gathering that string so that it's balanced on either side. I probably want the loop at the top at least as wide as the mask, maybe a little wider, and then the tails at the end. I'm going to put a pony bead on each tail, on each side, left and right, and this is going to become a stopper for the string when you go to adjust the mask. And this is one of the reasons I said you could make the string, depending on the fabric, you can cut it 3/4 of an inch, you can cut it 1 inch. Depending on how thick the fabric is and the body of your fabric, you might need to cut it a little wider and go to 1 inch so that that pony bead has that effect of holding the string in place when you go to adjust the length of the gathers on the side of the mask. And now I'm going to take both strings and I'm going to take 2 pony beads. And I like to do this with an alternating color, just so it's easy for the person wearing it. I've got those 2 beads, and now I'm going to pull both strings through both beads, one at a time. And when I pull these both through, it creates a drawstring adjustment, and this is going to be worn at the base of the neck. and the person can just reach behind their neck and just adjust it. They can even pull the drawstring a little closer to the side if they want. It's a very adjustable, flexible mask. I love this because you can lengthen it and make the pattern longer for someone who has a longer beard. You can also make it shorter for somebody that has a shorter beard, but I have made it for the average, going from short to like mid-long. But if you have an extremely long beard, then you can adjust it by measuring the individual you're making it for.
If you've enjoyed today's video and you enjoyed learning how to make this beautiful flannel mask, be sure to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel, ring the notification bell. That'll let you know when I post a new video. Thank you so much for joining me today. Be well, happy holidays, happy new year, and keep sewing. It's good for the soul.